Hey guys, welcome to our video. Today's video will be about a lecture teaching our students about the kid blood group system. Enjoy.
Hi, good morning class.
Good morning.
Today you guys will learn something new.
Okay.
What is this? Do you guys know there are many types of other blood groups? You guys know?
No.
Okay, today we're gonna learn about kid blood group system. So I want you all to find information about kid. Okay, before that, I will give you some introduction about kid. Okay? Okay. Kid blood group, blood group is a human blood that based on the presence of glycoproteins, or also known as JK antigen, on the surface of the red blood cell. And it is a major urea transporter in RBC, and it also helps to maintain the osmotic stability. Okay, other than that, antibody that bind to the kid proteins can cause delayed transfusion reaction, and also erythroblastosis fetalis, which is mean that erythroblastosis is immature red blood cell. Fetalis, fetus. Okay. And then this kid blood group also has been discovered in 1951, which has three antigen, JKA, JKB, and also JK3. Okay. And then the fun fact is urean transport across the kidney red blood cell membrane is 100 times slower than the normal red blood cell membranes. So now I want you guys to find out many types of other information about kid.
Okay, please.
A few moments later.
So that is called as hemolytic disease in newborn. The second disease is transfusion reaction, which is a serious complication that occur after the blood transfusion. The reaction is occur when the red blood cell is given during the transfusion are destroyed by the people immune system. And then the red blood cell also will become destroyed. This situation is known as hemolysis. Okay? Do you guys get it?
Yes, please.
Okay. Now, Aliah, do you want to present your points?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Okay, so I will be presenting about the characteristics of antigens and also antibodies. So for kid blood group's antigens, it has three types of antigens, which is JKA, JKB, and JK3. For JKA and JKB, it's known as
system. Okay, the GT antigen is found on the protein responsible for urine transport in the red blood cell and also the kidney. They are important in transfusion medicine. People with GTA antigens, for instance, may form antibodies against donated blood containing 2 GTB antigens, but there is no JKA antigen. This can also lead to hemolytic anemia, okay, in which the body destroys the transfused blood, leading to low red blood cell counts. Another disease associated with GTA antigen is hemolytic disease of the newborn, where in which a pregnant woman's body create antibodies against the blood of her fetus, leading to destruction of the fetal blood cells. Hemolytic disease of the newborn associated with GTA antibodies is typically mild through fetal cases that have been reported in many countries. The gene encoding this protein is found in mostly in chromosome 80. That's all for me, Miss.
Okay.
Hi, Miss. Now I'm going to talk about the importance of the kidney protein. So the kidney protein is a major urea transporter. It rapidly transports in and out of the RBC to maintain osmotic stability. The urea transport across kidney RBC membrane is 1,000 times slower than a normal RBC membrane. The transport of urea by the kidney glycoprotein in the kidney enables the kidney manila to maintain a high concentration of urea, which in turn enables the kidney to produce concentrated urea. However, the absence of the kidney glycoprotein is not associated with the disease. The RBCs in kidney individual have a normal shape and lifespan. Individuals with the JKAB phenotype is unable to maximally concentrate the urea. But it does not cause any other health problems or diseases. Thank you.
So, who want to go to today's lesson? Okay, Bobby, good.
There won't be any urea transportation. Secondly, it is also common in the newborns to have hemolytic anemia due to the JK antigens. That's all.
Okay, good job. Okay, so now you guys learn something new, right?
Yes, please.
Is it interesting?
Yes.
Okay, that is all for today class. See you in next class, okay?
Bye.
Don't forget your breakfast.
Okay.
And I play the role of student C.
Hi, good morning class.
Good morning,
Miss.